Good morning, everyone. Our today's theorem is, let A be a square matrix of order n. Then A into adjoint A is equals to adjoint A into A is equals to determinant of A into IA. That is the identity matrix of order n. This is a very important theorem of adjoint, and let's prove this theorem. First, we need to take a matrix A, which is a square matrix of order n. Write A as A11, A12, 1n, 21, 22, 2n, and last is an1 into nn. This is our matrix A. Now, the adjoint of A. We know the adjoint of A is the transpose of its cofactor matrix. That is, if Aij are the element of A, then its cofactor will be Aij. Now, form a matrix by these cofactors. Put the cofactor at the position of its corresponding elements Aij, and then take the transpose of that matrix. That is, interchange the rows and columns of that cofactor matrix. Then we will get adjoint of A. So our adjoint here is A11, A21, to AN1, A12, A22, AN2, and last is A1N, A2N, ANN. This is our adjoint matrix. Now the theorem says that A into adjoint of A is equals to adjoint of A into A is equals to determinant of A into IN. We need to prove this part. Start with A into adjoint of A. Now multiply A with this adjoint A. Okay. I write it here in 22, 821. 2, 2, 2n, and an1, an2, nn. Now see, when here I apply the multiplication method of row by column. So multiply the first row of A with the first column of adjoint A. Then we get a11, capital A11, plus a12 with this. 1, 2 into capital A12, and last is A1N with capital A1N. See, this is the multiplication of, this is the product of each matrix, each element with its cofactor, and then we take the sum. In first position, we can write the summation of A1K. This is the element and this is the cofactor, corresponding cofactor. And summation is rounds from 1 to n. In second position, for second position of first row, we need to multiply the first row with second column. Then we have A11 with A21 plus A12 with A22. And A1n with A2n. So here we can write the sum as A1k with A2k. Similarly, here we will have A1k with ANk. This is the summation A2k with A1k. Sum A22 and A2k with ANk. Here we multiply the second row of A with the columns of adjoint. In last row, we have ANK, capital 1K, ANK with A2K, NK with capital ANK. Now see, each summation runs from 1 to n. Then this is a n order matrix. Now we know that the summation, if we have the summation a1 aik with capital A jk, then this is equals to det A if I equals to j. That is, the product, if we take the summation of the product of its element with the corresponding cofactor, then we get determinant of A. But if I not equals to j, then we get 0. So if we take the summation of product of the elements with the corresponding cofactor, then we get determinant of A, and otherwise we will get 0. So this matrix is determinant of A 0 0 0, determinant of A 0, this is a determinant of A, and this also gives determinant of A, and other terms in this row is 0. Now take determinant A out from this matrix. The remaining part is IN. So the product of A with adjoint A give us determinant of A into IN. Now let's calculate adjoint A, the product of adjoint A with A. So now we need to multiply A in this side. 1n, write A here, A21, A22, A2n. Last is AN1, AN2, ANN. And use the method of row by column multiplication. Now, for first row, multiply the first row of adjoint A with each column of A. In first row, the first element is obtained by A1, multiplying A11 with A11, A21 with A21, AN1 with AN1. That is, the sum is here AK1 with AK1. Here, this is the summation of product of the element and its cofactors. In second position of first row, we have multiply the first row with second column of A, and we get AK1, AK2. In similar method, we have this KN. Proceeding in similar method, write other element of these rows and these rows. And in the last row, we have summation A KN K1, summation A KN of K2. And in this method, we have A KN with KN. This is our adjoint A into A. So, as here, when we multiply the elements with its cofactor, we get determinant of A, and otherwise we have 0. So, in this position, we have determinant of A, and other positions of this row will be 0. Similarly, we have this. And in last row, we have last element is determinant of A. Take determinant of A outside from this matrix. And then we have the remaining part is identity. So A into adjoint A is gives us determinant of A into IN, and adjoint A into A also give us determinant of A into IN. So both are same. So hence proof that A into adjoint A is equals to adjoint A into A, and it gives us determinant of A into the identity matrix. Hence the proof. Thank you.